about these heteropolysaccharides in this class. So these heteropolysaccharides, they are mainly contains more than 10 monosaccharide units, and these monosaccharide units are made up of more than one type of sugar unit in their structure. So since they contain 2-3 or more variety of sugar units in their structure, they are called as heteropolysaccharides. Under heteropolysaccharides, we have very important class of heteropolysaccharides is glycosaminoglycans, or also called as mucopolysaccharides. Glycosaminoglycans are also called as mucopolysaccharides. If you see the glycosaminoglycans or mucopolysaccharides or heteropolysaccharides, they contain repeated units of uronic acid and amino sugars. They contain repeated units of uronic acid and amino sugars. These uronic acids, if you see uronic acid, glucuronic acid or iduronic acid is present mainly in these heteropolysaccharides or glycosaminoglycans or mucopolysaccharides. Amino sugars, if you see, we have different varieties of amino sugars. Among these, glucosamine or galactosamine is the main amino sugar in this kind of heteropolysaccharides. So they contain repeated units of uronic acid and amino sugars. So uronic acid, it can be either glucuronic acid or iduronic acid. Most of the heteropolysaccharides or glycosaminoglycans contain this glucuronic acid as uronic acid sugar. And amino sugar, if you see, mostly glucosamine will be there in the mucopolysaccharides, or galactosamine will be there. Okay. So glucuronic acid or iduronic acid is the choice of uronic acid in case of these mucopolysaccharides. And amino sugars, if you see, glucosamine or galactosamine is the amino sugar. They are large complexes of negatively charged heteropolysaccharide chains. These mucopolysaccharides are large complexes of negatively charged heteropolysaccharide chains. Mucopolysaccharides are large complexes of negatively charged heteropolysaccharide chains. They are generally associated with small amount of protein. They are generally associated with small amount of protein forming proteoglycans. They are generally associated with small amount of protein forming proteoglycans. 5% protein plus 95% carbohydrate. 5% protein plus 95% carbohydrate means it is a proteoglycan. Proteoglycan consists of 5% of protein, 95% of carbohydrate content will be there. Glycoproteins, if you say term glycoproteins means proteins are 95% and 5% carbohydrates. So see the difference between proteoglycans and glycoproteins. Proteoglycans, carbohydrate content is more, whereas glycoproteins, proteins content is more. So that you should know, because proteoglycan, if we have studied this proteoglycan as part of the bacterial cell wall. So bacterial cell wall, gram positive bacteria, the proteoglycan layer, cell wall, thick cell wall is present, that is made up of proteoglycans. Means that proteoglycan is nothing but 95% of carbohydrate and 5% of protein. Glycoproteins are present in the cell membrane mainly. These glycoproteins consist of 5% of carbohydrates and 95% of protein content. So that is the difference you should understand. So because of the presence of the sulfate groups, these mucopolysaccharides, they have negative charges. Because of the presence of sulfate groups in mucopolysaccharides, they are negatively charged. And they absorb water producing gel-like matrix. Now they are important constituents. They are important constituents of extracellular matrix. They are important constituents of extracellular matrix, along with fibrous structural protein like collagen and elastin. So the ground tissue, like connective tissue, we have cartilage, we have parenchymal tissue, we have many kinds of tissue cells. So that ground tissue mainly, like let's say connective tissue, that mainly consists of these mucopolysaccharides. Okay, these mucopolysaccharides are part of the extracellular matrix and the ground tissue, which also consists of some proteins like collagen and elastin. So these heteropolysaccharides or mucopolysaccharides are part of the ground tissue substances, kind of like connective tissue, cartilage, in the muscle cells. These are mainly present. So heteropolysaccharides or mucopolysaccharides are very important constituents that are seen in the human body. So these are glycosaminoglycans. Simply, in short, they are called as GAGS, means glycosaminoglycans, also called as mucopolysaccharides. So these are large complex of negatively charged heteropolysaccharides, generally associated with small amount of protein, means they are all proteoglycans. The special ability to bind large amount of water, producing gel-like matrix that forms the bodies of ground substance. So these mucopolysaccharide, I told you, these are the components of ground substances. When these present in the, this kind of mucopolysaccharides are present in the ground tissue, what they will do, they have a special ability to bind with large amount of water. You all know that the cells and tissues, they consist of large amount of water. So the ability to bind with the large amount of water and producing gel-like matrix of the ground tissue, this is all possible just because the ground substances are consists of mucopolysaccharides. The unbranched long repeating disaccharide, contains uronic acid and amino sugars. So unbranched long repeating disaccharide contains uronic acid and amino sugar. They are mucopolysaccharides. Okay. Now amino sugars may be D-glucosamine or D-galactosamine. Uronic acid will be D-glucuronic acid or L-iduronic acid. Okay, now we have come to the actual classification of glycosaminoglycans. So these glycosaminoglycans are mainly classified into two types based on the presence of sulfur in that compound. They are classified into two types. One is sulfate-free glycosaminoglycans and the other one is sulfate-containing glycosaminoglycans. Sulfate-free glycosaminoglycan, sulfate-containing glycosaminoglycan. Sulfate-free glycosaminoglycan and sulfate-containing glycosaminoglycan. Sulfate-free glycosaminoglycan example is hyaluronic acid. Then sulfate-containing glycosaminoglycan examples, we have chondroitin sulfate, dermatan sulfate, keratin sulfate, heparin and heparan sulfate. These are examples for sulfate containing glycosaminoglycan. Okay, so sulfate free glycosaminoglycan, we have hyaluronic acid, and sulfate containing glycosaminoglycan, we have chondroitin sulfate, dermatan sulfate, keratin sulfate, heparin, heparan sulfate. Okay, we'll see one by one all these examples now. Chondroitin sulfate. So this chondroitin sulfate is an example for sulfate containing glycosaminoglycan. Okay, so if you see the composition of chondroitin sulfate, it is made up of repeating units of D-glucuronic acid and N-acetyl galactosamine 4 sulfate. These two are the repeating units in the chondroitin sulfate. Now see, these two structures I have shown and put the square bracket on whole N I have given, means so many repeating units of these disaccharide units are present in the chondroitin sulfate. So chondroitin sulfate is made up of डी ग्लूकुरोनिक एसिड एंड एन एसिटाइल गैलेक्टोजामाइन फोर सल्फेट. देर इज अ सल्फेट ग्रुप ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज अ सल्फेट कंटेनिंग ग्लाइकोजामाइनो ग्लाइकॉन. ओके, सो दीज आर द रिपीटिंग यूनिट्स इन केस ऑफ कॉन्ड्राइटिन सल्फेट. दिस कॉन्ड्राइटिन सल्फेट इज द मोस्ट एबंडेंट ग्लाइकोजामाइनो ग्लाइकॉन इन द बॉडी. कॉन्ड्राइटिन सल्फेट इज द मोस्ट एबंडेंट ग्लाइकोजामाइनो ग्लाइकॉन इन द बॉडी. This is widely distributed in bone, cartilage and tendons of the body. Bone, cartilage and tendons of the body. This chondroitin sulfate is mainly present in bone, cartilage and tendons. If you see the function of this chondroitin sulfate, cartilage tissue. In the cartilage, it binds with collagen and hold fibers in a tight, strong network. So cartilage. In the cartilage tissue, this chondroitin sulfate binds with the collagen and holds fibers of the collagen in a tight, strong network. Second function is it has role in compressibility of cartilage tissue. It has role in the compressibility of cartilage tissue in weight bearing along with hyaluronic acid. So it has the compressibility role in the cartilage, like weight bearing means the bone tissue. So this is also bone tissue. Bone tissue also you can see this substance chondroitin sulfate and found in association with the hyaluronic acid, which is a sulfate free glycosaminoglycone. Okay, so two types of chondroitin sulfates have been reported: sulfate position at C4 and sulfate at C6. So sulfated of this chondroitin sulfate can takes place at C4 or C6. Then second example, hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid is a sulfate free glycosaminoglycan. It contains repeating units of D-glucuronic acid and N-acetylglucosamine. D-glucuronic acid and N-acetylglucosamine. The repeating units of hyaluronic acid is 2 disaccharide molecule D-glucuronic acid N-acetylglucosamine. Is the repeating unit in hyaluronic acid. So this is an example for sulfate free containing glycosaminoglycan. Hyaluronic acid, if you see, this is also present in ground substances of synovial fluid of joints, vitreous humor of ice and connective tissue, tendons. These hyaluronic acid is present. So hyaluronic acid is the mainly present in the synovial fluid of joints and vitreous humor of eye and connective tissues also. So this enzyme hyaluronidase is the enzyme which can break beta-1,4 linkages. They are present in high concentration in testes. Hyaluronidase enzyme is also present in high concentration in the testes, seminal fluid, and in certain snake and insect venoms also. This enzyme hyaluronidase is present. Hyaluronidase is mainly able to cleave the glycosidic bond beta-1,4 glycosidic linkages that are present in the hyaluronic acid. This hyaluronidase enzyme concentration is mainly high in case of testes and seminal fluid, also seen in certain snake and insect venoms. So if you see the functions of hyaluronic acid, it acts as a lubricant and shock absorbent in the joints. It determines the charge selectiveness of renal glomerulus. It acts as sieves in extracellular matrix. Hyaluronic acid permits cell migration during morphogenesis and wound repair. Hyaluronidase enzyme of semen degrades the gel around the ovum and allows effective penetration allows effective penetration of sperm into ovum. Then another example of glycosaminoglycan or mucopolysaccharide is dermatan sulfate. This contains uronic acid, iduronic acid. Sugar, uronic acid sugar is L-iduronic acid, and amino sugar is glucosamine. So the repeating units in case of dermatan sulfate, if you see, it is L-iduronic acid and N-acetylgalactosamine 4-sulfate. So iduronic acid and N-acetylgalactosamine are the repeating units in case of dermatan sulfate. So dermatan sulfate, the name itself indicates it is present in the skin. That is why it is called dermatan sulfate. It is present in the skin, that is dermis. So it is called dermatan sulfate. Present in skin, cardiac valves and tendons, this dermatan sulfate is seen. Function of dermatan sulfate is, it is present in the sclera of eye, where it has important function in maintaining overall shape of the eye. So the shape of the eye is maintained by the sclera of the eye. So this is containing dermatan sulfate. Next example for glycosaminoglycan is heparin. It contains D-glucuronic acid. It contains D-glucuronic acid plus glucosamine. So the uronic acid is D-glucuronic acid and amino sugar is N-sulfoglucosamine 6-sulfate. So the repeating units are D-glucuronate and N-glucosamine, N-sulfoglucosamine. So this is the only intracellular glycosamine, glycosaminoglycan, only intracellular glycosaminoglycan. Intracellular means this is present inside the cell. Whatever we have discussed, the mucopolysaccharide examples till now, like chondroitin sulfate, dermatan sulfate, okay, hyaluronic acid, these three are extracellular glycosaminoglycan, whereas this heparin is intracellular glycosaminoglycan. Remember, extracellular means that is present outside the cells. Intracellular means inside the cells. Intercellular means in between the cells. So you should understand these terms. Intercellular means in between the cells. Intracellular means inside the cell. Extracellular means external environment of the cell. That is extracellular, which is present outside the cell. Okay, so these terms also you should understand. This heparin is the only intracellular glycosaminoglycan made up of repeating units of D-glucuronic acid and glucosamine. Heparin importance, if you see, it acts as an anticoagulant. Anticoagulant means it prevents the blood clotting. If you see, if we have any cut in the body, the blood comes out, oozes out. The blood oozes out. After some time, the wound will get healed automatically because of the formation of clot, right? So that is clotting mechanism will get activated wherever there is a wound and blood leaking out. So that clotting mechanism stops the loss of blood if any wound or injury is there. But when you add an anticoagulant, what will happen? The blood will not coagulate. So it will be in the liquid state only. So it will not coagulate. So heparin is one such compound which can be used as an anticoagulant. This heparin is found in granules of mast cells that line the arteries of lung, liver, kidney, spleen. Okay, so this heparin is also found in granules of mast cells that line the arteries of lung, liver, kidney and spleen. The strongly acidic due to presence of more sulfate group. Heparin is acidic in nature due to the presence of more sulfate groups. Heparin helps in the release of enzyme. Heparin helps in the release of enzyme lipoprotein lipase. Heparin helps in the release of enzyme lipoprotein lipase. Lipoprotein lipase. This helps to clear the lipidemia after a fatty meal, also called as clearing factor or lipotropic factor. lipotropic factor. So heparin, what is it will do? It will helps in the release of an enzyme called lipoprotein lipase. This lipoprotein lipase, what it will do? It will clears the lipids that are present in the blood. So after a heavy lipid fatty meal, like if you eat some burgers or some pizza or some bread with cheese and butter, okay, in such cases what will happen? The absorption of fats will increase because you had a fatty meal. So it, the content of lipids in the blood increases, but deposition of lipids in the blood is not good for the health. So it should be cleared from the blood. It is cleared by some lipotropic factors. Heparin is one such compound which releases the enzyme called lipoprotein lipase, which clears these lipids from the blood after a heavy fatty meal. So this is called as lipotropic factor. This is also called as clearing factor. Now another compound example for mucopolysaccharides is heparan sulfate. Heparin is different, heparan sulfate is different, okay. Now this heparan sulfate is same as heparin except some amino groups carry acetyl groups. So this heparan sulfate is having some acetyl group, and the percentage of sulfate groups is only difference between heparin and heparan sulfate. Heparan sulfate is a extracellular glycosaminoglycan. Heparin, I told you, it is intracellular glycosaminoglycan, means which is present inside the cell. This heparan sulfate is extracellular. This is present outside the cell. So extracellular glycosaminoglycan. This heparan sulfate present in basement membrane. Heparan sulfate present in basement membrane. Present in basement membrane. And acts as ubiquitous component of cell surface. This heparan sulfate acts as a basement membrane in the which is present as a basement membrane for the cells. Another example for mucopolysaccharides is keratin sulfate. This keratin sulfate, if you see the repeating units in keratin sulfate, is D-galactose and glucosamine. D-galactose and glucosamine. Here there is no uronic acid. If you see the composition of keratin sulfate, there is no uronic acid. So keratin sulfate is the only glycosaminoglycan. GAG means glycosaminoglycan. It is the only glycosaminoglycan with no uronic acid. With no uronic acid. So there is no uronic acid, but still it is a mucopolysaccharide. It is made up of galactose and glucosamine repeating units, D-galactose and N-acetylglucosamine repeating units. N means number is 10, 15, depends on the structure, okay. So this is a polysaccharide made up of repeating disaccharides of D-galactose and D-glucosamine. So these are the only glycosaminoglycan with no uronic acid. Example, keratin sulfate. This keratin sulfate found in cornea and tendons, cornea of the eye and tendons. The two types of keratin sulfates are reported, keratin sulfate 1 and keratin sulfate 2. Keratin sulfate 1 is mainly present in cornea, keratin sulfate 2 is present in the skeletal muscle, is present in the skeletal muscle. Functions, if you see the functions of keratin sulfate, it helps in maintenance of the corneal transparency. Corneal transparency, because this is a important component of the cornea of the eye. This helps in maintenance of the corneal transparency. So this is a proteoglycan, means most of the substance is made up of carbohydrate and less amount of proteins are present. So this is how complex hyaluronic proteoglycan is present in the ground tissues. So it forms a network of tissue. This gives support and strength to the ground tissue. Okay. So these are the examples for glycosaminoglycans. Glycosaminoglycans, they differ from each other in number of the following properties, like they differ with respect to their length of the chain, amino acid composition, uronic acid composition, and they also differ between linkages between the components, presence or absence of sulfate groups, then the attachment of sulfate to the sugar molecule, the nature of core protein linked to the glycosaminoglycan, the tissue and subcellular distribution of glycosaminoglycans. Okay, so these are the differences, and if you see the functions of glycosaminoglycan, they are structural components of extracellular matrix. They contribute to the turgor of various tissues. They act as sieves. Sieves means the filters. Filters means a thin membrane. They act as sieves in the extracellular matrix. Glycosaminoglycans facilitate cell migration. They also act as shock absorber at the joints. Glycosaminoglycans help in maintenance of compressibility of cartilage tissue, and they have a structural role in sclera and cornea corneal transparency. Okay, KS1 means keratin sulfate 1, DS means dermatan sulfate, HA means hyaluronic acid, CS means chondroitin sulfate. These are the functions of glycosaminoglycan. If you see the other functions, heparin, which acts as an anticoagulant, is a glycosaminoglycan, and it determines hyaluronic acid, which determines the charge selectiveness of renal glomerulus. Formation of cell membrane and synaptic vesicles is also dependent on these heteropolysaccharides. Okay, so these are the